Hello, I am Amethyst Lunatari. Welcome back to Let's Play Shardlight Blind. Tiberius has sent us to go spy on these people. We're gonna have to do something for them. We have to do a special knock this time. So we want to be accepted into their ranks, is basically what it is.
She doesn't look very friendly.
She isn't very friendly.
Hi. Well, that's just rude.
She's still mute, or something.
Tough-looking guy.
You again?
I'd like to speak with Danton, please.
Fine. Wait here.
Mm-hmm. I want to look around this place.
So you're back. What is it now?
I know who you are, and what your people are doing. I'd like to help.
I'm flattered that you want to help us. But I feel we have some matters to resolve first.
Oh, yeah?
What matters are those?
Enough of these games.
What?
You're
oh, no.
going to have to start telling me the truth if you want to get out of here alive.
What? I have been. Let's not be so drastic.
Don't play coy with me, Blondie. Do you think I'm stupid? I had you followed when you left here. I know you went to the Ministry of Energy. Now I'm only gonna ask you this once, and I want the truth. Are you working for Tiberius, or aren't you?
We have to tell her, yeah. What if we say I was doing a lottery job for him, but that's all?
You do realize people need to do lottery jobs to survive, right? It doesn't mean I like the guy.
A lottery job? Oh, I see.
And what other choice have I got? It's not like I can walk up to the Ministry of Medicine and buy a dose.
Huh, she bought it.
I'm so sorry. You don't deserve what's happening to you. This is why we have to act. They've been beating us down for so long, nobody remembers a time when they were prosperous and free. Struggling against the system may not be pretty, but it's the only way we can improve our lives.
Danton, if she's got a connection to Tiberius, she could prove useful.
You know? You're right. Having another double agent would be beneficial to us now that we've lost Milton. But I'm not gonna make you this offer for free. I'd hate for Tiberius to outbid me for your loyalty. Instead of hoping your lottery ticket gets chosen, how about you end up with as many actual doses of vaccine as you want?
Really? Now I feel bad for leading these people astray, but maybe we can tell them later. I think it's... I figure it'd be foolish to tip our hand so quickly. I mean, what if Tiberius found out? Maybe dead. You have access to vaccine?
What are you talking about? You have access to vaccine?
Not just yet. But if all goes to plan, we will. I'll tell you more as soon as you help us out with something. Are you familiar with the junk vendor and butcher in the market?
Yeah.
Gordon and Gus? Of course. They're good friends of mine.
Then it may interest you to know that they work for me.
Oh.
I had no idea.
They usually spare us some of their extra supplies, but they've been unable to keep up the last few months. I suspect they've fallen on hard times. See what's going on with them and help them if you can. Once you've finished, come back here, and we'll do what we can for you. Oh, and when you talk to them, use the code phrase, "I've got the perfect life." That will let them know you're working for me.
Okay.
Now get to it. Don't come back here until you've finished. And remember, I expect your loyalty. If you set foot anywhere near the Ministry of Energy, I don't want to see you meet an unfortunate end. I'm sure you understand.
Okay. Well, we didn't tell them the truth, but we can't go back to the Ministry of Energy anytime soon. I was afraid they were going to tell us to, like, shake down Gus and Gordon, I believe. No, Gus is not our brother then. Because it was Gus and Denby we saw running around in the picture in our home.
Hey.
What do you want?
How did you join up with Danton anyway?
How do you get involved with Danton anyway?
She's family.
She is?
Yeah. When her parents died of green lung, she was left homeless and forced to beg on the streets. My folks took pity and adopted her. She can be kind of hot-tempered and rush into things, but I try and keep her in check as best I can.
Keep on doing what you're doing.
Mm.
He looks busy. I better not.
That's far enough.
Okay. Figured that would be the outcome.
How's it going, Clem?
Not so bad, Amy.
What's your take on our friends downstairs?
Interesting company you keep downstairs.
So, you're working for them now, are you?
It seems that way.
We've been hard-pressed to find new recruits. You're a welcome sight. People are scared. Between the plague and rumors of the Reaper going around, nobody wants to get their hands too dirty if they could help it. Well, except for me.
I guess it's easier to be consistently miserable than to take a tough road to happiness.
You're starting to sound like Danton now. Be careful where you say that.
See you later, Clem.
Take care of yourself, Amy.
So, he is part of their organization. I didn't think he was officially part. I mean, I wasn't sure. I figured could be. Okay, Gordon.
Hey, Gordon.
Amy, what are you looking for?
You. I've got the perfect life.
You know, if you helped me today, I'd have the perfect life.
You mean... Ah, I see. Be careful where you say that, Amy.
Right, sorry. Anyway, what are you doing to help the others?
A little extra scavenging for items they might find useful. But lately, I've been too distracted by the situation with my daughter.
Your daughter?
You'd think that for all the crap I collect, I'd have found something to at least try and make her a more effective mask. Only place I haven't had a chance to check out lately is the old Centrex factory. Even though I'm not sure there'd be much of use in there. I just want her to be safe. Losing my wife was bad enough. I can't lose her too.
I know, Gordon. I know. I'll keep an eye out for what you need. You just try to relax.
That would be awfully kind of you, Amy.
Anytime.
The Centrex factory.
Have you got anything good for sale?
As a matter of fact, I did manage to get something new which might interest you.
Oh, what is it?
An aristocrat guard ran through here earlier and dropped his flintlock pistol.
Nice.
It got a bit damaged, but I figured you might be interested in messing around with it for parts.
Yeah, I'd love to. What are you willing to trade for it?
Well, it's mostly in new condition, so it would have to be something fairly valuable. But you know I'm not terribly fussy. Anything you think I might like?
What did you say you'd take for the pistol?
What was it you said you'd trade for the pistol?
Anything of similar value. Those aristocrats have some pretty nice stuff. But you know I'm not terribly fussy.
Bye, Gordon.
Goodbye, Amy.
Okay, so do you want... I don't suppose you want chalk.
I don't think he'd...
No, you want the crossbow.
I can't just go...
Oh, I was going to give it to him. I'm not going to give him my lottery ticket.
I don't think...
Okay, we don't have anything valuable yet.
That's how the government keeps us informed. Sometimes I wish they had some sort of shut-off switch, though. I'd love to be able to tear them down. It's not worth the risk. I can't just go around shooting everything I see.
All right.
Citizens, this is a reminder that the Ministry of Medicine...
I don't want to give away my lottery ticket.
...weekly screenings for Green Lung.
Of course, if they, give us vaccine, like, I guess they're going to raid the Ministry of Medicine or something, then we won't need a ticket.
Just couldn't stay away, could you?
No, I haven't quite reached today's quota of looking at dead meat.
So he's not our brother. I've got the perfect life.
How are you doing today, Gus? Because I've got the perfect life.
Shh, not so loud.
Sorry. So, how long have you been, you know?
About a year now.
But why? Isn't it risky for you?
Sure, but to be honest, I kind of like the excitement. Makes me feel like I'm part of something important.
You are.
Plus... things need to change. Just look around you. We can't live like this. Kids can't grow up like this. Danton's gonna bring back the old days.
Maybe.
Anyway, I was told you were having some trouble, so I wanted to help.
Yeah, not sure what you can do, but swing by the farm if you want. Pop was asking about you the other day. If nothing else, talk with him a bit. He misses you.
See you later, Gus.
You bet.
Okay, so these are just like childhood friends then. Friends of mine.
Just couldn't stay away.
No, see you later.
You bet.
Well, I'm talking to everybody else. Well, that's a kid.
I haven't got anything to
say. All in white, I guess. I thought it was a statue. She never has anything new to say.
Amy, hello.
Oh, okay. Oh, she didn't say she was part of it. Good harvest, though.
Looks like you had quite the harvest.
Yes, thankfully. Though nothing is keeping very long, weeds have become a big problem. Anything you want? You're looking very skinny these days. You should eat. Take a pumpkin. Half price for you. You can make pumpkin soup. You need your strength.
No, it's okay.
I don't think we have
any
money.
One of these days, you'll get so skinny, you'll turn around and I won't be able to see you anymore.
It's all right, Mariska. I ate yesterday. I'll be fine for a little while longer.
No, no. You worry me when you say things like that.
Relax, it's okay. I'm not dead yet.
You mentioned something about weeds?
You said something about weeds being a problem? What are they called? What do they look like?
Blue burglar. It grows very fast, very difficult to control. Pretty blue flowers, though. Too bad they ruined my vegetables. Luckily, I finally got them under control. They won't come back for a long time.
Blue flowers? Now that you mention it, I think I've seen those someplace. Thanks, Mariska.
Where?
I have to go now.
Okay, you come back and see me again soon, all right?
I'm a little nervous if we say that she was not mentioned as one of the people that we could say this to. But what if we do?
Hello, Mariska.
Amy!
I've got the perfect life.
You know, as tough as things are, I feel like I've got the perfect life.
I'm happy for you, Amy. You're always so positive.
I have to go now.
Okay, you come back and see me again soon, all right?
Hmm. We're gonna get killed?
Hi, Nelson.
Good to see you, Amy.
I've got the perfect life.
Coming out here, reading books, it makes me realize I've got the perfect life.
Ah, I see. I do as well. It gives me pleasure to help how I can, although I'm too old to fight.
What made you decide to join them?
Danton makes some good points, despite being a bit overzealous.
Okay.
The favoritism the aristocracy showed their elite patrons after the plague began is completely inexcusable. Once the poor couldn't fund their medical research, we were quickly cast aside for those who could. Danton is brash, perhaps a bit foolish, but her ideals are what we need.
Maybe he has some special books we can read.
I think I'd like to read for a while, if that's okay.
Of course.
Oh no, nothing new.
Actually, I haven't got-
As you-
Yeah.
I can't ring it by hand. That bell is used to announce the arrival of one of the aristocrats, or their...
Alright. So she might say something different. What if we tell this guy?
Excuse me?
May I help you?
I've got the perfect life.
Why would I want to embrace death when I've got the perfect life?
The Reaper smiles upon your joy. Let us hope he takes you now, while you are happy and not in anguish.
I really should be going.
So be it.
Okay. So Mariska and the Reaper cultist are apparently the only ones not part of this. So there's the Centrax factory, and there's Pop's farm. Let's stop by Pop's farm.
Oh god, that smell. I think I might be sick.
Amy, is that you over there?
Hey Pop, Gus said you'd been asking after me.
It's been ages since I last saw you. Come over here and let's have a look at you.
Hmm. But I want to look at your stuff first. Gus told me you aren't doing so well.
Are you under the weather, Pop?
I'm not, but I can't say the same about my sheep. Take a look around. Hell, just take a whiff. That's the stench of failure.
And
things
death.
Are bad. Don't know if we'll be able to dig ourselves out of this hole.
What happened to your sheep?
Did your sheep get sick? What happened?
Ran out of feed, so half of them starved to death. It's not a pretty picture. Haven't been able to find anything else they'll eat. The farm's gone barren, and now the only thing I'm feeding is ravens. Truth is, if I can't come up with a way to keep the rest of the flock from dying, I'm done for.
I'll keep an eye out for anything that might help.
That'd be mighty kind of you.
I don't suppose a bucket with a piece of wood in it would help. So there are more sheep still alive.
What did you say the problem with your sheep was?
Ran out of feed, so half of them starved to death. It's not a pretty picture.
Excuse me,
haven't been able to find anything else they'll eat. Truth is, if I can't come up with a way to...
I'll keep an eye out.
That'd be mighty kind of you.
Sounds like we're both having a pretty rough day.
I think we're having the same kind of day.
What's the matter?
This morning I found a man underground. He'd been crushed underneath some rubble. And pulling that trigger was the hardest thing I've ever had to do.
I'm sorry, Amy, but it sounds like you did the right thing.
Did I, though? I could have found someone to help. Why did he have to die?
You listened to what the man wanted, it sounds like. In this hellhole, that's all we can ask for in our last moments.
I guess you're right.
Of course I'm right. Like he said, even if you had gotten him out, you wouldn't have had much of a life left to live. It's not something anyone likes thinking about, but it's reality.
I know. I mean, I see death almost every day, but this was different somehow. Thanks, Pop. I think I needed to just get that off my chest.
Anytime, Amy.
What's with all the ravens?
Why are all these ravens hanging around?
Well, they're hungry, too. Now that they got plenty of carrion, it's an open buffet for them. Little bastards have gotten bold, too. Nothing I do seems to keep them away for long. At least having them around means nobody comes snooping around. They run off at first sight of them, thanks to that kooky Reaper cult.
Oh, yeah. What do you know about the Reaper cultists?
I didn't realize you knew so much about the Reaper cult.
I don't, and I don't want to. They're just a bunch of freaks who think worshiping the Reaper is gonna make them die quicker.
But I thought the Reaper was just a story.
It is, but they think the ravens are a sign that the Reaper is on his way to take them away from their woes. So naturally, any half-wit who believes that crap and sees a raven gets scared and goes running in the other direction. Bunch of bullhickey, all of it. Anyway, it's best if you stay away from the Reaper cult. Don't want to put any ideas in your head.
Don't worry. I met one of them earlier. I'm not going anywhere near them if I can avoid it.
Really? We're trying to get in that church. I've got the perfect life.
I'm sorry you're having trouble, Pop, but I've got the perfect life.
Is that a fact?
Yeah. Did Gus not tell you?
Tell me what?
Nothing. Never mind.
Whatever you say, Amy.
I wonder if some people know and they just don't want to reveal to us.
What did you say the problem?
Ran out of... haven't been through this.
I'll keep it. That'd be... I have to go now.
Come back and visit whenever you like.
Okay, look around.
Pop's been like a second father to me. I remember when he was always smiling and joking, but lately he's just been looking really old.
He is old?
These don't look like they've been used for quite some time. They look like they would fall apart as soon as I touch them.
Maybe we can find some feed at the Centrex factory.
Poor thing. No thanks. I wish these birds would stop staring at me. Shoo! It doesn't seem to be doing a very good job of scaring away birds. Can't understand why. That gas mask on the face is pretty damn creepy.
Maybe if we help him, he'll let us take the gas mask from the scarecrow and give it to Gordon for his daughter.
Say, Pop, would you mind if I took this gas mask?
Or we can just take it.
That's fine. Not doing too great a job scaring the birds, so I doubt taking it off will make much of a difference. Hope you weren't planning on using it, though. The filter's no good.
That's fine. I'm sure I'll find some use for it.
Probably still better than a cloth mask.
The gas mask's filter is empty, which makes it pretty useless.
I guess we should find some a filter for it. Can we chalk it up?
I'm not sure. I shouldn't mess with it any further. It doesn't seem to be doing a very good job of scaring away birds. Creepy little thing. Shoo! That one is feasting on the corpse of a sheep. At least someone around here is getting regular meals. Shoo! No thanks. Poor thing. Poor thing.
Poor thing?
Poor thing. That old thing has been broken for years. I don't know why Pop doesn't just take it down. It is way beyond repair.
Skyline?
From out here, the city looks kind of whole, like the pictures in Nelson's books. Home is on the outskirts to the east. It's just perched in the tree, watching me. Shoo!
They don't like that. They always remember a face, you know? Maybe not always, but often, you know.
That one is feasting. It's the way back to the city.
Alright. I could try to give this...
It's the way back to the city.
I could try to give this to Gordon. It'd still be better than a cloth mask.
Hey, Gordon.
Amy, what are you looking for?
What was it you said?
Anything of similar value, but you know I'm not terribly fussy.
Bye, Gordon.
Goodbye.
How about this?
Gordon, I know you said you wanted a gas mask. I've got this one, but the filter is empty. Would you at least be willing to trade the pistol for it?
Yes, this is good. If I could get a filter, this would be exactly what I need. Take the pistol, but if you find any filters...
You'll get your filter, I promise. I'm sure somebody around here has to know something about them.
Yeah, now that you mention it, Nelson's probably the guy to see about that. He's got books on just about everything.
Okay. I'll go visit him.
Hey, Gordon.
Amy.
About that gas mask.
I'm still on the lookout for something to fix your gas mask.
Thanks. Hopefully something to replace the filter won't be too hard to come by.
Bye, Gordon.
Goodbye, Amy.
So now we got a flintlock pistol.
The pistol is only slightly damaged. It hasn't got any bullets, but the flintlock mechanism still looks like it works. Should be useful if I need to light anything on fire.
Oh, really? So we'll use it?
Attention, citizens. 2 minutes of silence will be observed.
I don't see how I can use that there.
In remembrance of last day.
I'm not ready to trade it back just yet.
Curious what she says sometimes. Let me check up in on some of these people again and we'll go talk to Nelson.
How's it going, Clem?
Not so bad, Amy.
See you later, Clem.
Take care of yourself, Amy.
Good conversation.
Excuse me?
May I help you?
I really should be going.
So be it.
Just couldn't stay away, could you?
No, I haven't quite reached today's quota of looking at dead meat. See you later, Gus.
You bet.
Hello, Mariska.
Amy, hello!
I have to go.
Okay.
Alright, let's talk to Nelson. I have another book for us.
Hi, Nelson.
On filters.
Good to see you, Amy.
I think I'd like to read for a while.
Of course.
Science. That one wasn't there.
I want to read up on science.
Wonderful. I think I've got just the book for you.
Filtration systems. Patrick Radke. Several methods of filtration can be used, but be it for liquids or gases. However, a very useful material found in most filtration systems is activated carbon. I'm going to write some stuff down. Activated carbon. Well, you might be able to help him even further. Maybe we'll find that at the factory, like I said. Activated carbon has many uses, such as gas purification, decaffeination, gold purification, metal extraction, water purification, medicine, sewer treatment, air filters in gas masks and respirators, etc. The ease of production of activated carbon makes it one of the most useful materials in modern science. Activated carbon is produced from carbonaceous source materials such as, coconut husk. Oh, I have wood. Peat. Wood. Core. Choir. Oh. Lignite. Or coal. It can be produced either by physical or chemical reactivation. Oh. Well, maybe, like a fire, right? Yeah! If we burn the wood, we got carbon. And it's already in a bucket. We have the flintlock to do that with. Sweet. In physical reactivation...
Interesting. This information could be pretty useful.
Hint, hint. In physical reactivation, the source material is developed into active carbons by using hot gases such as steam or oxygen. It must be heated at extremely high temperatures in the range of 600 to 900 Celsius. Steam. Oxygen. I'm writing this stuff down. I mean, we might be able to take the book with us, but... I'm sorry, I don't have to keep referencing it. In chemical reactivation, the raw material, i.e. coal or wood, is impregnated with acid. A strong base... or salt. The raw material is then carbonized at a lower temperature, somewhere in the range of 450 to 900 Celsius. Chemical reactivation is usually the preferred method due to the lower temperature requirements as well as a shorter time needed to activate the material. Okay, we got two different reactivations then. So, physical... Alright. So I'm putting brackets here. Physical. I'm literally writing this stuff down. So this one's chemical. -450 to 900 degrees Celsius. Okay. Right, so good thing I wrote that down. I do not have the book with me.
Hi, Nelson.
Good to see
you. Know where I can find salt?
Do you happen to know where I could find some salt?
Salt? I know Gus uses it to cure his meats. Why not try asking him?
Okay, that's for the chemical reactivation. So we need acid, a strong base, or salt. Alright, thanks.
I'll see you later, Nelson.
I look forward to your return.
Anyone wishing to enter the vaccine lottery may do so.
Yo, Gus.
Just couldn't stay away, could you?
No.
Where do you usually get the salt for your meats?
I'm looking for salt, like the kind you use on meats. Where can I find some?
Well, there's plenty out at the salt flats just outside the city, but it's kind of a pain in the ass to go out there. The walk takes a while, and lugging the stuff back's a chore.
It shouldn't be a problem. How do I get there?
You know the abandoned South Coast rail yard near Fripp Square?
Nope.
Just follow the main track down about half a mile and you'll find it.
Thanks. Will do. See you later, Gus.
You bet.
I need to have that memorized.
Just couldn't.
No. See you later.
You bet.
All right. Because I didn't get it all. Something about Fripp's South or something. So before I go to this Centrex factory, let's check the salt flats. Is all this salt?
I can't believe I never knew about this place. It's the perfect spot to get away from everything.
I like the train.
Am I hearing things or is that music?
No, you're hearing something.
Looks like this train has been here a long time. I wonder when the last time it actually ran was. It's locked. How odd. This door looks as though it's been in use recently. It's a long hike back into the city.
Is this salt? Dead tree.
I'm surprised this thing hasn't been chopped down for firewood yet. It's way beyond any sort of help now.
Excavation.
Looks as though someone has been excavating for salt here. Probably Gus. Plenty of salt has been dug up here. I'll take a handful.
Salt.
Salt is useful for preserving meat, but it can also have some more creative applications.
Yeah. Should we put it in the bucket?
Okay. I'll rub salt into the wood. That should prep it for carbonization. I've got a piece of wood in my bucket.
Which is salted. Well, that's the physical, isn't it? Oh no. Looks like for either of them we need coconut, husk, peat, wood, coir, lignite, or coal. So we have wood. And then we add steam or oxygen for physical. Or for chemical, we add acid, strong base, or salt. But we also have to heat it up somewhere. Can I just use this?
I'm going to need something much more powerful if I want to set this wood on fire.
Yeah, I had a feeling. Okay.
The ticket is for this.
I didn't mean to hit that. Anything else to look at? No.
It's locked. That's not going to help me get this door open. That's not going.
Well, then I don't know if we can get in here right now.
That's not.
Yeah. I guess we're leaving? We definitely have to come back there and check that out.
When the Reaper comes around, he'll take away your soul.
Hey, guy.
Hi, Amy.
Oh, okay.
I'll see you, kid.
Bye, Amy.
Love these short conversations. So, can I do anything in here? Would a combustion engine help?
You'll be done one day. I've hit it. I don't see how I can.
Guess not. Well, coal was one of the other things, not oil.
No time for that now.
When is there time to use a hook?
Beware the red-eyed ravens. They mean the reapers near. He'll take away your loved ones and all whom you hold dear.
Okay, I guess we're going to the Centrax factory next, because I'm not sure what else to do. Maybe there we can make this filter for him.
Anyone wishing to enter the vaccine lottery may do so by visiting the appropriate ministry and applying for a work permit.
And maybe we can get some feed for sheep there? Maybe? I'm not sure. What you got? Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek
attention,
adventure.
Citizens, if you spot